First official medal of the nationwide George Washington Bicentennial Celebration. This is the first time that the government of the United States has ever used platinum in the manufacture of medals. This platinum medal will be presented to President Hoover. As the sculptor of this official medal, I present it to you for your inspection and approval.
I'm particularly pleased with the way this medal has been reproduced in platinum. I understand there's enough platinum in this medal to make at least 160 wedding rings.
Here we have the obverse and reverse sides of the finished bicentennial medal, honoring the 200th birthday of George Washington.
Destiny and the welfare of ourselves and of our children are profoundly involved in the initiative and the vision of those charged with the responsibilities of government in these United States during the coming year. The Democratic Party asks that responsibility in no spirit of overconfidence, in no spirit of mere partisanship. It seeks to lead because it is the more representative of the people as a whole. And it believes that in greater measure it can bring to the people an attainment of their welfare, an attainment of their ideals. I deplore the tendency to blame all of our present troubles on the president. He is perhaps the victim of a theory which holds that the control of the Republican Party entitles the holders of the reins to use that historic party for the purpose of personal gain. He and his associates have perhaps shown a lack of high capacity to contribute leadership in the solving of a national crisis. The battle of the democracy is pointed not at the rank and file of the Republican Party, but at those who today direct its policies. But the battle of the democracy can never tolerate abuse heaped against the person of the President of the United States.
Now for a little novelty, my specialty, skating on stilts.
Thank you. workman out here? Mike Murdy.